What is the most desired item on the server right now? What do you think? Well, at least for me, it clearly is iron. And pretty much every time when I log onto the server, the first thing I do is I came by iJevin's small iron shop here, was hoping to grab me some iron, and lo and behold, every time I came on, it was taken. So, you know, very sought after product here. And as I never got any iron, I'm gonna buy this all now. So I'm set with iron for a little bit. I need it, man. So, sorry, other hermits, this time, my turn. One stack, one diamond. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Okay, 17 diamonds it is. Let's get that. 1, 2. Alright. So, minus that one. Oh yeah! Finally, I got some iron, man. Yoo-hoo! I need to make a lot of hoppers today. Because today we're gonna keep on working. Oh yeah, we're playing Hermitcraft, by the way. You know, I have this tendency to not say, you know, what we do in the beginning. And, you know, I do that, but where we are, often I forget. You know, that's not professional YouTubing. Professional YouTubing would be, and you say every time when you start the video, hey, my name is Doc M. And I'm here on the world famous Hermitcraft server. Before I do anything in this video, you have to hit the like now and subscribe if you haven't. Also consider to check out my 8 other channels. I do amazing stuff there too. You know, stuff like that. I'm glad that I never went down this rabbit hole, to be quite frank, making other channels. It would be smart, you know, for how YouTube works, say, technically, I should never post anything but Minecraft on my channel, and whenever I do, it will not get the views and it will hurt my channel in the long run. But bro, running another channel? I don't know. What is happening here? For all your terracotta and glazed terracotta needs. Holy frickeroli. Is that another Concorp shop? That sounds like a super smelter thing to me. Terracotta. Oh, okay. Wow. 3 diamonds per stack, good prices. Dude! Welcome to Fall. No idea who would make this shop, but this would require a lot of smelting. And a lot of smelting smells like Concorp to me. It is crazy how fast stuff gets populated here, right? I mean, there's a dead horse in the hole. Alright, did run did run by a horse. Ah, oh, he buys everything. Okay, we got the beacon back there. Yeah. It's crazy, yeah, how people creep up here already and build stuff. Pretty cool. And let me make iron blocks. How many can we make? Noise. Pretty good. Okay, and then let's go for one run of harvesting. And while we, you know, sugarcane, we need to get paper. And while we do that, I briefly talk about the plan for today. So, Ren is gone in America now. Whoops. And why is that so? Because Ren is one of our representatives as Hermitcraft ambassadors, so to speak, at the Minecon, right? This is this weekend. And Ren's there with Iskial, Scar, and I think Mambo and a few others. And so he had to pre-produce videos. And he knew we want to get the stock exchange done. So he has, in his videos, he also did some other stuff, of course, but he worked on the stock exchange, so there will be some spoilers in my upcoming episodes, right? To what he did, because, yeah, there's no other way for us to do it. So he pretty much told me on Discord, yo, Doc, I did this and this and this. I got 3 episodes, which will contain Also stock exchange content, but you know, go ahead, do your thing, do the redstone stuff we need. So when I come back, we can maybe already think about the grand opening. And that's the job now. We have a week to complete our tasks, our redstone tasks, which are not minimum. This is quite a bunch. We now need to build 10 vaults with individual vault door lock keys. And cool look, we have a design for that. 10 of them. And then I'm already working at the moment at an epic 4x4 vault door design, inspired by some tweets I got for the looks, but for the technology I'm working on it with Kaz, my Zuma at the moment again, good guy, and I just wanna, you know, help promote his stuff and get his name out there more, so I'm trying to get him involved with projects here. And so far it's been going great, he's having super much fun with it, and yeah, I'm liking that. So, yeah, that is that. Then we also need elevator solutions. So, everybody is going for bubble elevators these days. So now I'm thinking for the bank and it's our bank vault and the stock exchange as such. And as it's also not a very big elevator, we probably have to build there. But we might go for something really fancy. Maybe even a full closed cabin elevator. You know, like a real elevator, quote unquote. For that part, I just think it would justify, would be justified to build that. So that's another design I have to develop. Or maybe I can use a design that already exists also. We will see. But that would be cool, you know, up and down elevator pretty much. It's an extra safety layer and coolness factor. So this is three pretty huge redstone projects we have lined up for the week. So this will be redstone week. But all of the designs are really slick, I think. I'm trying to come up with, you know, as I said, with some new shizzle you guys will like, and efficient, good looking door design. For now I'm working on, that's the main focus. Good in survival, but looks really slick. And yeah, we're really close. So, I mean, really close to having something really awesome. So I'm really happy about that. How is the sugarcane situation? Well, we have two chests. Well, let's go in. Let's go in. So we left the bikini there, obviously. So yeah, here we will have a situation that will forever and ever trigger anybody that has OCD to some degree. And I'm really sorry for that, but this will not change. We'll probably have to live with it. You see it, right? For some reason, here we got two blocks. Here's only one. Yeah. The building is off-center. It really bothers me, because, you know, last time I was like, huh, why do we have a 4x4 there? Something went wrong. And yes, indeed. So it's a bit off-center, but changing it all now is not going to happen. So I thought about, how are we going to be able to live with that? We could change the facade. Maybe that would be the easiest thing to do, right? I'll talk about that. But in case we don't do it, just think about it like that, guys. You can even the odds at the stock exchange, right? Everybody can win here. So we're evening the odds here, and it doesn't matter if it's off-center. And maybe it becomes this viral comment, why is the stock exchange off-center? Yeah, it is what it is. It should be, well, it's also, you know, up there we want to do a bell for the stock exchange. People could ring. And it was also planned to be, oh man, like I really, we should really move this all over by one block. Oh, but it looks really good in here now. Man, Ren did a great job. I like the color combos now with the stripes there, here. Looks good. Looks insanely good. Yeah, clean. Darkish wood we agreed on. Then we had a balcony going on top, you know. Really good stuff. But yeah, check out Ren's videos for super detailed explanation about our ideas with the building here and so on. That'll help. So down here is the vault then, right? And those will be the individual vault cells. And I would say I just go ahead now and I build one of these to show you what they can do. But pretty much what we need to achieve is each vault, 10 of them, belong to a company. And they get an individual key to the for their vaults, and they will be able, you know, to have a look at their profits here, how much they made from their stock at the moment, right? Their stock money will be stored in here, so they can come in themselves, but also us as the stock exchange experts, you know, we can go in here and deposit money. So to be able to do that and it doesn't get too chaotic or whatnot, I thought about one more thing we really need for the buying up here. And that is, we need another chest somewhere around here, which are the payment chests, right? So if you take out stuff here, you put your payments into a chest that is probably, we'll figure out a good position. Most likely it makes sense when it sits in front. You put it in the payment chest, and we, as the owners here, we come by, and then we put the money into the vault. And then the owners of the bank here, or of the bank vaults, or of the companies, then can go down and check the amount of diamonds they make. They cannot take it out, though, you know. You need their cash in the system to be able to trade back and forth, right? But it's technically their money, right? We also cannot take it. And our cut then will be, we always take 10%, right, of the complete trade amount. So we just go ahead, and then we go like, aha, this and this was traded, it's like 10 diamonds, 10% of 10 is 1, belongs to us. And this is how we're gonna run the facility here. Obviously, we have running costs and stuff. All right, so with that said, I would say I will go ahead and build the vault, or one of the vaults, and then I show you the design, and then I have to build 9 more of them.
A few moments later.
All right, so we have the first vault here completed. Let me fill in some blocks. This will be, of course, all filled in. And yeah, I need to move all the vaults over. On our original design, I told Ren I need 2 blocks of space to the sides here. Sadly, we don't have that now. So yeah, I will have to modify everything here and scoot it over. But it's all right. It's all right. So this is how our vault doors look in open state at the moment. So the idea is, I have the keys here right now. You know, the players come down and then we have all their individual company vaults down here. So in this case, for example, Concorp, right? And so this is the default state. The light in there is off, right? And everything is closed up like that. Iron bar, crazy door to make it even more safe down here. It's all about safety. So toss that in and then your vault opens. Whoop. You have a light source on top that then goes on, right? Looks nice and shiny in here. And also wanted to put more carpets. Then you have some individual lockers here for whatever stuff you want to store in the vault. And here, oh yeah, I need to place that properly. Let me see. Like this. This is your actual stock exchange money vault, right? We'll probably name the Schalke boxes here as well, but this is your wall safe that contains all your riches that you get from trading, right? So the thing with trading is, if somebody has diamonds in here bought into their company, right, theoretically it's their money. They could take it out, they could take it out, but if somebody then goes ahead, you know, and wants to sell stock of them, and they have no funds, you know, to pay for that stock or pay out for that stock, it will be hefty fines. So they're encouraged to leave their funds in there, but it's newly generated funds. We don't take their diamonds, right? Only if they want to invest in other companies or in their own company, of course, then they would need new diamonds. But other than that, you know, we just encourage people to buy into their companies, and I think it's a great thing. So yeah, this is how these walls look. And when you're done with your business in there, you lock it. We made it intentionally so that you have to lock it again, because that is just what you do, you know, when you have a vault, you actively lock it. We didn't want to do a pressure plate solution there. So I'll just put the key here temporarily, because of course it's a filter key and you can only use it here. So how does this thing work? Well, obviously here we have a basic key filter, right? And then I can show you the redstone a little bit in case you want to build one of these. It's very compact and easy to do. So here, this is the standard design for item filter, right? Here we have six signs and then the Concorp keys. I use this same thing, for example, at the beacon setup over at the Guardian farm. If you want to know how this item filter works, you can maybe look that up, but that's the standard item filter. You see that comparator here, two blocks, repeater, and then torch there. And then we have two hoppers that sit on top of each other, and one hopper points into the dropper here. And there's another dropper on top, right there. And yeah, that pretty much spits out the keys again when you throw them in. And then from here, we just grab the signal observer monostable that pushes a block under this piston. And this is the lower part of the door that closes. And then we just bring the wire up, right, to the top for the top part that is opening and closing, you can see here. And for the light, we pretty much just have it inverted. Whenever the power is off, the light needs to be on here. That's why we have this torch there and then just a light source there, right? So relatively simple and quite easy to do. And yeah, this is one booth. And now I need to build 9 more.
1 eternity later.
So I was digging out below here, right? Just clearing out some space for the redstone we need to install here, and then I find this randomly here, not connected to anything, and it says, I am a word that begins with the letter I. If you add the letter A to me, I become a new word. But that sounds exactly the same. What am I? AI? I? EI? I? What is going on? I have keys but no locks. I have a space but no room. You can enter but you can go out. You can't go outside. What am I? What is going on, man? This is creeping me out. Who made this and for what purpose? And what are the weird riddles I don't want to think about? You let me know the answers in the comments. This creeps me out, man. What is this? Who made this? And how did they get in there? And what? Dude, this is really weird. Like, really weird. I might even be able to keep it. I mean, I don't know. I swear, I have nothing to do with it. This is not role-playing or, you know, anything I had planned out and whatnot. Like, for real. I don't know why it is here and who made it. And here we have, by the way, a super ghost block. Can't place anything in there. Yay. Ah, those super ghost blocks are so annoying. Yeah. Really weird. Yeah, let's keep on working here. Really tripping me out though.
12 seconds later.
If you're working on a redstone project that contains several same designs, you know, I would really highly recommend you go by the block by block, layer by layer principle. Pretty much you prepare the locations of your important pieces. For me, it was the hoppers. Did them first, and now all of the cells we need to build are arranged like this. And yeah, we can repeat the same thing over and over, and that makes things way easier. So for example here, you know, we do the item filter, that is always the same thing. Sadly, I needed to remove the signs here with the cool riddles. by whomever, you know. So this is for the item filters, and yeah, we need pretty much the same thing over here, but it's just mirrored a little bit. Then you just go ahead and, you know, add stuff layer by layer like this, and that makes it really easy and saves you like a lot of time. Now, of course, here at the super ghost block, we need to have a repeater. Of course. Can we place it? No. Oh my god. Okay, I need, like, to be able to fix this, I need admin. This is mega ghost block, but at the moment nobody's on. I'll wait. Pretty sure Carp or Zuma show up at one point, and then they can remove this. It has to be this block, right? Of course. Of course. All right. And then you just do this, you know. And now I would say whatever, let's do comparators on all designs, you know, so I don't have to switch around much. Boom. And I go through, do the comparators for all of them right away. And this way you can speed up your output a lot and get a lot of redstone done. If it's the same designs, don't say, ah, today I'm gonna make two of these and then tomorrow a few more and whatnot. It'll just drag out, man. Just knock it out, build it efficient, and yeah. And then you should have no problems, you know, now the two redstone on there and so on. And I'll keep on going, and we should be able to quickly build that in under 20 minutes. Whoops, where am I jumping? If I really grind it, for sure, quicker than 20 minutes.
So much later that the old narrator got tired of waiting and they had to hire a new one.
Hoo-wee. Yeah, that clearly took longer than 20 minutes. I'm adding the final touches here, but we are pretty much done. I can show you around here a little bit. In, yeah, the Hermitcraft Federal Reserve, pretty much, right? We gotta see it like this. This is the Federal Reserve. So, now, I was in the Nether, right, getting more quartz, and it seems it's still not enough. I still need more. Yep. Then I was going about and was thinking, man, there will be a lot of diamonds down here, right? What if somebody of the other hermits, Iskall or some other criminal, because he clearly has a hitman service, so Iskall must be considered potentially law-breaking, right? So what if one of those guys plans a heist on the place, man, and robs us? So we need security down here. The vault here needs to have security systems, player detections, alarms, maybe even traps. Yep, I need to think about that. But yeah, before we think about that, let's look around. Lots of red carpet here, very posh and clean. Don't worry, this will be kept too. Potentially some other colored carpet, not quite sure yet. But yeah, those are the individual booths, right? And I just have the key up there stored at the moment. The others are not programmed yet, as we need to figure out, you know, yeah, which companies it will be. But it's the 10 we need it. And up there where I have these blocks, there will be our representative blocks. We have upstairs as well, precious blocks. You know, the same as above, same scheme. So if, for example, I don't know, iTrade has the emerald block, right? The iTrade booth would have it here too. And then these pillars up there, so glass separations that make no sense, but this is a bank and banks do that. They have barriers and things, and you wonder, why is it here? What is behind there? And yeah, we can put some decorative stuff back there. I'm counting on Ren. Maybe we stack some gold up here, you know, this could be some gold blocks. We have leeway, we can go deeper here. This could potentially go, yeah, another, yeah, it could go back, but there's some chests hidden here, so, but yeah, we could stack some gold blocks in there, actually, you know, to make it look a bit more precious. Maybe use some of the armor stands to lay out gold bars or so in item form, in a sense, if that is possible, would be cool. And yeah, whole thing works. Let me put some stuff away. So the owner of the vault would step up and they had their key, right? And they would then toss it in here, get the key right away, and then they can come in here, store all their precious belongings. And here is the actual, this is the Schalke box that is reserved for the trading, right? And when you're done, you lock your vault again and take your key with you. It's not going to be up there. It makes no sense if everybody can take the key, right? And it's nicely locked. Light goes off inside again, and all is fine, and it will be all the same here. And I think took me a while to figure out a decent design. We need to have carpets at certain locations. It's just what it is, because we cover some of the redstone here to have it nice and flush, but also I have some lights hidden in here somewhere. Oh, I need to sneeze. Oh, please, no. Oh, the bane of every YouTuber, sneezing. Right, so looks really clean. I plan to stretch out these pillars a little bit higher. It might even end up with a room height like that. Quite possible. And then we kind of have some support beams, maybe these also quartz pillars, and then some wood in the ceiling or so. But Ren will help out a lot with the design of it. Yeah, it's all pretty clean and compact. Sitting nice back here. We have enough room, you know, to move about below later for maintenance and all this, the good stuff that might needs to be done. And then we have a bit of space left back here still. So I was thinking maybe, I mean, we have space here for another 4x4. Maybe you can build another design here for a different 4x4. And we would have another main vault back here that could A, be where Ren and I, you know, hoard our riches we make from here. Or B, it could be an extra vault with special, because this thing will have high security. This will be a room when you come in there, not doing the proper things or not having the proper security or anything. And if you're in here, all hell will break loose. You will die. You know, I'm not kidding you. This is some serious business. So this is with the safest place on Hermitcraft. I might go even so far that I will ghost generate super ghost blocks, so you can't even breach. There's a trick to do it. Kept it a bit secret. Don't know if I want to show it. So yeah, that would definitely be a thing. Have a super vault back here too. Need to talk to Ren. But that would be cool. Or we could have some other stuff here. We will see. But let me know if you like the idea of the super vault with traps and security. Yeah, and then, you know, going up here around. And yeah, I need to go mine more quartz. We're blasting through quartz here. This is nuts. Yeah, but I think it will look great. It will look great in the end. We can have whatever here. We will see. Maybe some paintings as well. Other, you know, stuff that is considered precious. Leave some feedback. Some diamond blocks, of course, you know, maybe some emerald stacked in here or so. All kinds of possibilities. You just let me know in the comment section. I'm always my ears wide open for nice feedback. Talking about nice feedback, I've been getting really nice feedback from my Patreons lately for the server we've set up with my team there. And it's really great. It's running now smoothly. We have a nice box. We have 20 active players most of the time. And it's a survival server like Hermitcraft in a way, but also based around the Minecraft World Tour. So pretty individual, actually, for me. And yeah, at some point, soonish, I don't know yet, because yeah, Hermitcraft is so much work and we're so busy here. I want to start the World Tour, and then this server will be a big part in it. So yeah, if you're interested to check out my Patreon community, feel free. Link in the description. For $5, you know, you get access to the Discord. You can hang out and check out what's going on. And the server is $10 then, in case you wanted to play. But I recommend maybe, you know, you come by, hang out on the Discord before a little bit, and then see if you like the community. But I can, you know, it's awesome. I'm so thankful to this whole Patreon community. It's great guys and girls and people, and we're having a great time. Yesterday movie night, sadly I missed that, and so on. It's all kinds of good stuff they organize and we have going on together. So yeah, I really was quickly want to talk about it. For a long time, you know, I was hesitant with the Patreon stuff, right? I always thought, hey, you, the viewer, and I, we have a pretty good deal. I make videos, you try, if possible, not to have Adblock on all the time and watch my stuff. If you cannot do that for whatever reason, at least leave a comment, leave a like. And by this, you know, I could make a living with the ads that were running on YouTube. Now, recently, though, that has changed a lot and things have been very crazy on YouTube. It seems they are slowly stabilizing now again. But still, yeah, crazy times, and there was a lot of financial pressure. And then eventually, as everybody told me, man, do a Patreon, stop being so weird about it, I did it. And since I ever did it, first of all, of course, it helps me a lot from a financial standpoint. It's really great. And secondly, the community that grew around there, really, really awesome, you know, because if you do this for a while and your channel gets bigger and bigger and then you have more and more people come and go, eventually it gets super hard to have really individual connections with community members. You sure recognize regular viewers of by their comments and so on, you know, but it's hard to really talk with each other for a bit, hang out, you know, do something together. And with the Patreon, I actually can do that, which is really cool. I personally enjoyed it a lot, and it also plays a huge role why I enjoy YouTube so much lately again. Because one thing I always hated is when, you know, you're this anonymous guy, just this YouTuber, and you it's hard to have a connection with your viewers, a close connection at least, right? And yeah, with this Patreon thing, that came back, and this also plays a huge role. The personal connection to somebody also even motivates you more to do the best you can, right? So that's why I really think Patreon is cool. If you feel you want to support me there directly, go ahead. I really, really appreciate it. And yeah, that's it. My talk about Patreon, I hope that was not too baggy now and like looking like I want to rob you of your money or so. But it needs to be addressed. It's a huge help for me, and I think it's fair. You know, I'm not trying to rip you off there. Alright, so in any case, thanks for watching, my friends. I'll guess I have to go quartz mining for a little while again. And then later I have to keep on working on designing the cool door we want to build, because I really want to make it epic. See you next time. Bye, guys!